Wrestling Challenge comes to you this week from the Hare Arena in Dayton, Ohio. Johnny Walker, Executive Vice President of the arena, is here to welcome the WWE.
I'm Johnny Walker, President of Dayton's Hare Arena Conference and Exhibition Center, and we'd like to welcome the WWE stars to Dayton, Ohio, the birthplace of aviation.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Wrestling Challenge. I'm Gorilla Monsoon, joined by Bobby the Brain Heenan, and you can hear this capacity crowd behind us. They're ready for the action, so settle back in your favorite chair. We've got it personified coming at you right now.
No.
Just 1 week away from SummerSlam 88, and all the luminaries of the World Wrestling Federation are joining us here this week.
Unfortunately, Brother Love is here, Brian.
And you're here.
Oh, please.
Jesse the Body Ventura, guest referee, his special guest, the undisputed Intercontinental Champion, the Honky Tonk Man.
And the Colonel.
Well, that remains to be seen.
Brutus the Barber Beefcake will be doing some cutting and some strutting, and then the powerhouse from Canada, Dino Bravo, looking to prove that once and for all he is the strongest man in the world. And the Hart Foundation also, minus, I might add.
That's their downfall right there.
All that action coming at you, a whole lot more. Let's go to ringside. Well, I like the music, Brain, but that's where it ends.
What do you mean that's where it ends?
Well,
the Honky Tonk Man coming down now with the Colonel.
Not too long ago, the Colonel had a whole lot of champions in his stable. Now he's down to this.
Walk.
And maybe after SummerSlam, he won't have this.
Don't bet on it.
Well, SummerSlam coming up just 1 week away. He will meet Brutus the Barber Beefcake in Madison Square Garden for the last time. Brutai says he wants to do some cutting and some strutting, and he wants the gold around his waist.
Like you said, for the last time.
Bell's gone, we're underway. SummerSlam, the hot item on the lips of everyone. The momentum just building.
It wouldn't surprise me if Brutus the Barber Beefcake was defeated by the Honky Tonk Man, then cheap shot at him and cut his hair off that way. You know, he'll do anything to get a hold of that hair. He's that kind of a guy.
I was afraid you'd be of that opinion.
Don't you think so?
I think a lot of exciting things are going to happen August 29th in Madison Square Garden. Mega Powers taking on the Mega Bucks. What a classic that's going to be. Honky Tonk Man, indeed, I'm sure, some sleepless nights worried about Brutus the Barber Beefcake. But he has one consolation. This, in fact, will be the last time they'll meet. Here's some words from Honk.
Good.
1 week away, baby. SummerSlam 88.
It won't be long now, will it, Brutus? The final meeting. SummerSlam 88. The Honky Tonk Man, the greatest Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion of all time. We'll get to play the final tune for you, Brutus the Barber, just for you.
You know, I think he may be outsmarting himself here, Brain. If this is the final time that these two guys are allowed to meet, if Beefcake takes the belt from him and the title, that means there isn't a rematch clause. He can't get it back from Beefcake.
Well, I thought it was just that Beefcake's got his last opportunity to meet the Honky Tonk.
No, the ruling is states that this will be the last time that these two will meet. What does that mean to you?
Well, that means Jack Tunney has double-crossed another person again, right?
Oh, boy.
Honk doing a number here on young George South. Oh, Mr. Dropkick stepped right out. That's where the experience comes to play, Brian.
Exactly.
No substitute for experience.
And it helps to have a good manager in your corner.
Oh, yeah, you know about that, right?
My specialty.
Yeah, I guess so.
Well, both of those guys could use a haircut in my book.
It's a style now.
Another big match I'm looking forward to, Brain. World Wrestling Federation title match as part of SummerSlam Demolition, putting the titles on the line against the Hart Foundation, the Anvil and the Hitman.
You know, normally with Jimmy Hart in the corner with the Hart Foundation wanting to regain that title, I'd have to go with them. But since Jimmy Hart is going to be in the corner with Mr. Fuji, a
traitor,
well, they stab him in the back.
So now it's four against two, right? Fuji, the Colonel, and Demolition on one side against the Hart Foundation. Oh, I don't like those odds.
All fair and love and war, and they love that championship, and this is war.
Yeah, I guess so. Look at this now. Honk just measuring young George South. Root elbow right in the sternum area. That'll give you a negative attitude.
Look at him. Does he look worried?
Oh, he's, nice smile. He's not worried about George South. He's worried about Brutus the Barber Beefcake. Surprised he even took this match this close to SummerSlam.
This is a way to show everybody he is the greatest Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion of all time.
You mean even better than Pat Patterson?
Who?
No, forget it. Oh, look at that. Right into the corner. Missed it. Ran right into that top. Hercules got a most interesting match coming up, Rain and SummerSlam. He may get a chance to meet up close and personal Damian. Here comes the shake, rattle, and roll. Oh, look at that awesome move. Snapping of the neck. Forget about this one. It's history. Very impressive. Let's go up and get the official word. Honky Tonk Man chalking up another one in the win column. I guess he wishes that this was August 29th.
Oh, I imagine he does. Get it over with. Get that creep off your back.
He's not going to sing, is he? Give me a break.
I hope so.
Honky Tonk Man doing his thing here on Wrestling Challenge. Let's go back and take a look at what went down only moments ago.
See, George South signaled he was going to do. He took too many steps. Just outsmarted by the greatest Intercontinental Champion.
So now, sort of telegraphed that move, too.
He certainly did.
Well, once he wraps you up and sets you up in that position, when he's got you in that compromising position, he slaps that shake, rattle, and roll on you. You can forget about it because it's lights out time. Let's go up to Mike McGurk.